Good morning, guys, and welcome back to my channel. Or if this is your first time here, welcome to my channel. For today's video, I decided that I'm going to take you guys along for a productive Monday in my life. Most of my Mondays look like this, give or take, like the homework that I have to get done, as well as if I have to head to campus at night for a sorority event, which tonight I actually have to do. But for the most part, my Mondays look like this, and for the most part, a Monday is one of the most productive days of the week for me. Just because I don't have school on Monday, so I really take this day to get everything done that I had to get done over the weekend, like make sure everything is finished up and ready for the week. I take this day to run all my errands, to meal prep, to get everything organized. I really just take Monday to start the week off on a right note and a very productive note. So I thought I would take you guys along for a Monday and kind of show you guys how I get that done. I'm also going to give you guys some tips and tricks a little later on as to kind of how I organize my Mondays and like my productive days and how I get done everything that I need to get done. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this video, and if you do, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. If you haven't done so already, head on down there and subscribe. It is around 9:30 in the morning, so I just woke up and I got ready. I also headed over to Starbucks and I picked up a coffee. I'm now at Stop and Shop about to do my grocery shopping for the week, because on Mondays, this is when I like to meal prep for my school week, which is Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and I also pick up all the necessities and things that I need for the rest of the week. So like milk, cereal, granola bars, fruit, like I said, everything I need to meal prep. And today I'm also going to pick up some candy for the program that I have to hold tonight for my sorority, because Halloween is on Thursday, so I thought I would bring the girls some candy, make their time a little worthwhile for being there for me tonight. So I'm gonna head inside and go do that, and then once I'm done grocery shopping, I'm gonna head over and get some gas. I like to fill up my tank on Mondays, just because, like I said, my school week starts on Tuesday, so I need enough gas to get to and from Stony Brook Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. So that's what I'm gonna get done for this morning. I like to run my errands very early in the morning, A, because the cleaning people come to Harris's house around 9 a.m. so I like to get out of the house so I'm not in their way, and B, I just like to get it over with. No one's ever really here at Stop and Shop this early in the morning. It's definitely more quiet around this time of the morning, so I like to get all my errands done so then I can get home and kind of get a game plan for everything else. So I'm gonna go grocery shop, I'll take you guys along for gas, and then when we get home, I'll show you guys kind of how I organize my Mondays and kind of create a plan of action for everything else. So yes, hope you guys enjoy this video. I'm gonna go grocery shop now. I just unloaded all my groceries from my car and I put everything away, and I'm about to get ready to sit down and do some homework. But I thought I'd quickly sit down and kind of give you guys some tips or tricks on how to stay organized and kind of plan out your days to really help you stay on track. So there's two main things that I do in my life that really help me stay organized and on a schedule, and that is using a planner and time blocking. So quickly, I'm going to go through how I use my planner. Maybe how I use my planner is different than how you use yours, but you can implement some of the things that I do in what you do, and it'll help you be more productive and stay on track. So this is my planner. To be completely honest, I used to never be a planner user. I used to never think that they were very helpful, but college came around and I realized planners are the way to go. So once I got all of my syllabi for all of my classes in the beginning of the semester, that's when I sat down and I filled out the calendar portions of my planner. So my planner comes with an at-a-glance calendar before it has the week-by-week part. So I got my syllabi and I sat down and I wrote out everything in the like at-a-glance calendar. That's what I like to call it because I get to see everything at a glance. And as you can see, some things are color-coded. And as you can hear, Stella is barking. It's the dog walker. You guys, if you've been following along, you know that. Try to ignore her barking. So as you can see, some things are color-coded. So for me, I really like color-coding things just because it helps draw my attention to a certain thing and kind of makes this look more organized. So for me, everything that's in pink, those are larger assignments or exams that I have coming up. Everything that is in yellow are smaller assignments or homework assignments that I have coming up. And then the things that are not highlighted are appointments, like doctor's appointments, obviously for me, or other things that I have to do, like sorority events, phone call appointments, all that kind of stuff. So I really highly recommend color coding if you feel like even after you fill out your calendar, you still are left kind of not really confused, but it's hard for you to follow. So I definitely recommend color coding if you don't do that. That really helps me kind of organize my calendar. And then, like I said, I have the week by week portions in my planner, and this is where I plan out all my homework for the week. I plan out every single day what homework assignment I'm going to do, just so I can look at my planner and know, okay, today this is what I have to tackle. And I also split up my homework assignments. I find that kind of splitting up my homework makes it more manageable. So for example, like I said, I'm sitting down to do some homework in a few minutes, and that homework is reading a textbook because I have two exams coming up on next Tuesday. So for one of my classes, there's a lot of textbook reading, so I like to split it up. So for this past weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, I had my planner read for 200, which is the class, so it's 200. And in parentheses, I put the number of readings that I wanted to get done. So Friday it was 4, Saturday it was 4, Sunday it was 4. And then for today, I have read for 200, Family Life, which is another book I have to read, plus 3, which means that I have 3 more textbook readings to do. And then I also have to type some notes this week, so I split that up among the days. And I also split up my studying. I write when I'm gonna study in my planner, just so I actually study. I feel like doing this is a way for me to hold myself accountable in a way, to make sure I get these things done when I have to get them done. But it also helps me stay organized, stay on track, and make sure everything that I have to get done is getting done. So planners, highly recommend. The second thing that I really recommend you to try out if you feel like your life is very unorganized or you have a hard time staying on task is to time block your life, which this is something that I never really did until, like I said, college came about. And ever since I started time blocking, my life has been so much more organized, so much more on schedule, and I just feel like it's really easy for me to get done all the things that I have to get done. So basically what I do to time block is I use the Reminders app in my phone. So in my Reminders app, what I basically do is set aside blocks of time for certain things that I want to get done in the day, not just homework. So for this morning, I had between 9 and 11, I wanted to focus on running errands. And then from 11 to 1, I have in there that I want to focus on doing my homework. And then from 1 to 2, I want to be meal prepping. And then from 2 to 5, I want to be doing homework again. And then from 5 o'clock on, I have like sorority stuff down because I need to head to campus for some events for my sorority. So time blocking is a really good way to help you stay on track. It kind of keeps you focused on one task at a time, so you're not overwhelmed by all the things you have to get done in the day. Because sometimes if you just look at a list of things you have to get done, it's really easy to get overwhelmed with what you have to get done. So when you time block, you're just looking at that one thing that you have to get done, and you can get it done, check it off, and move on with your life. If you guys have been struggling with staying organized, especially if you're in college, but even if you're not in college, try using a planner, try color coding your calendar, and try blocking out your days. I really, really, really live by these things, and a lot of my friends ask me, like, how do you have such great time management? Like, how do you plan your life out like this? And it's just these things. So I wanted to share with you guys these few things just because this is my Productive Monday, and Mondays are when I fill out my weekly assignments. Like this morning I woke up and I wrote out all the homework that I wanted to get done for the week. And I also take the time to time block my days. So in my phone, I have this entire week basically time blocked out, so I don't have to worry about doing it day to day. So this is how I stay productive. This is how I stay organized and everything like that. So hope you guys find these tips helpful. I'm gonna go now and read this dreaded textbook, and I will talk to you guys probably when I meal prep. All right, so it is around 1 o'clock now, which means it is time for me to meal prep. So this week is actually a really easy meal prep week for me just because my night class was canceled on Thursday because it is Halloween. So I only really need to prep dinner for Tuesday night, but I think I'm gonna make a little bit of extra to bring for lunch on Wednesday when I'm at my internship. So what I decided to get is a rotisserie chicken and some green beans, as well as some egg noodles, which I already have in the cabinet. I think that's what I'm going to make. So I'm gonna get out all my ingredients and everything. I'll show you guys specifically what I got, and then I'm going to meal prep. This shouldn't take me that long, but I also think I'm going to make myself some lunch because I'm pretty hungry. So I think I'm gonna make just eggs and toast. That's like a go-to that I make when I'm home on Mondays, just because it's super easy and I'm already in the kitchen like cooking things. So I usually just make some eggs. So let me go get out all my things that I need to get out, and I'll show you guys what I got, and I'll get meal prepping. I got out all of my ingredients. Like I said, I picked up a rotisserie chicken. This is like my cheat meal prep, if that makes sense. Like whenever I'm super lazy and I don't feel like actually meal prepping anything or doing anything too crazy, I just pick up a rotisserie chicken. So that's what I did for this week. These are the egg noodles I'm going to be making, as well as green beans, like I said. And I just remembered that I had a little less than half a bag left from last week, so I'm gonna finish these up and then I'll open up the new bag if I need some more. So I'm gonna get all this going, cut this up. I have my water on the stove already, waiting for that to boil for the egg noodles, and then while this is in the oven and this is on the stove, I will make my eggs for today. Done. I have all the chicken that I cut up. I basically just cut up the white meat. That's the part I like. String beans are done. Egg noodles are done. And I made myself eggs and toast to eat right now. It is 1:20, so this meal prep took me only 20 minutes. This is such a quick and easy meal, not just for meal prepping for school, but it's a good idea for dinner if you're a mom and you need something really quick and easy. Highly recommend. So this I'm gonna put in the fridge now. This I'm gonna go eat. I do have to just put the dishes in the dishwasher and clean this up, but I'm gonna go eat my lunch once all that's done, and I'm gonna get back to work. So it is around 5 o'clock right now. I actually need to get my stuff together and get ready to head out the door in a little bit. Like I said earlier, I need to head out to campus tonight for an event for my sorority. Actually, two events. So I have to host an event tonight. As vice president, I have to host like certain sisterhood activities. So one of those is tonight, and that's at 9 o'clock. But at 7 o'clock, I have a resume building workshop with my sisters as well. So I definitely need to head out in a few minutes just because I think I'm going to hit so much traffic. 5:30 on a Monday. I just have a feeling I'm gonna hit some traffic heading out there, but I am waiting for Harris to get home so I can say a quick hi and bye before I leave. So I need to go get my sweater on and find my booties. We have to wear like business casual, so I'm throwing on some booties And I need to get together everything that I need for tonight. Like I said this morning, I bought some candy for the girls, so I need to get that together. I also need to get together the supplies that I need for tonight for my event. So I needed to cut up like paper for the girls. I also needed like a bowl. I needed a whole bunch of supplies. So I need to get that together and make sure I have that. And then once Harris gets home, I'm gonna say my quick hi and bye and we will head out to campus. I don't think I'm gonna be home until like 11 o'clock tonight. So tonight is definitely a late night. But that's okay. I'm feeling very productive. I got my readings done that I had to get done before, and I also typed my notes for those readings because I highlight in the book. And then I type everything that I highlight so I can look it over before the exam. So I got all that done. I'm feeling very productive with my day. So I'm gonna patiently wait for Harris to get home, say my quick hi and bye, and then head out to Stony Brook. All right, so it's pretty dark in my car, but I just sat in traffic for over an hour. And then once I got onto campus, I drove around for another 10-15 minutes looking for a parking spot. If you commute to Stony Brook, you know how horrible parking is on this campus. But I found a spot. I'm here, but I'm late, so I need to get my stuff together and head over to my resume workshop. And then, like I said, at 9 o'clock is the event that I'm holding. It's 7 o'clock now. So once both those events are done, I will check in with you, and that'll probably be around 10 o'clock, and I will do the dreaded drive home. Alright guys, so I just got back to my car. It is around 10 o'clock. The resume workshop was actually really helpful, and I think my program went really, really well, so I'm excited and happy about that. But like I said, it's around 10 o'clock now, so I'm going to do the dreaded drive home, and by the time I get home, most of the house is probably going to be asleep. So I think I'm just going to end the video here. So I hope you guys enjoyed getting a look at my productive Mondays. I hope you guys enjoyed the little tips and tricks that I gave you guys on how to organize your life and how to kind of manage your time. I swear by those, so definitely try them out, and if you do, let me know how they go. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. If you haven't done so already, head on down there and subscribe. And with that being said, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.